What happens if you get picked up by a tornado? We all know what tornadoes look like, especially if you've watched Twister or The Wizard of Oz. But what are they? The American Meteorological Society's official definition is a violent rotating column of air in contact with the ground, either pendant from a cumuliform cloud or underneath a cumuliform cloud, and often, but not always, visible as a funnel cloud. We know that they are big, and they are scary and can carry cars, cows, and even a couple of houses. They can range from a simple dust storm to a force that can wipe out an entire town. But could anybody actually survive being picked up by a tornado? And if they did survive, could anyone come away unscathed? These are some of the questions we are going to answer in this video and find out what it feels like to be picked up by a tornado. Before we look at this, a quick reminder to give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying it, and also to subscribe to Brain Impact for more videos just like this one. But now, back to the tornado. A lot of us would probably not know that there is more than one type of tornado. The slenderest and most common form of twister is the rope tornado. While many twisters develop into larger forms, most start and end as rope tornadoes. A cone tornado is the one that everyone pictures when they hear the word tornado. They are wider at the base than rope tornadoes and much wider where they meet the thunderstorm, giving them conical appearance. Because their footprint and path are wider, they can leave a larger trail of destruction. Wider still and broader than they are tall are the wedge tornadoes. These are some of the largest and can be among the most destructive. They are usually rated at EF3 or above, and with a width of half a mile or more, can leave a significant trail of destruction. The May 2013 El Reno tornado in Oklahoma was 2.6 miles wide at the height of the storm. A few supercell thunderstorms spawned multiple tornadoes at the same time. Multivortex describes a tornado that has two or more smaller subvortices swirling around the center. Non-supercell tornadoes are circulations that do not originate with organized storm rotation, but rather develop from a vertically spinning parcel of air occurring near the ground. Myths are full of fantastic and destructive creatures. Giants sauntering vengefully into unsuspecting towns, for example. In reality, all the calamities we are likely to encounter are due to natural phenomena and human will. But of all the destructive powers in our world, none resembles the ferocity and form of those mythic monsters quite like tornadoes. These storms descend like a dagger from the clouds, they tower over the tallest buildings like titans, and when they lash out at their surroundings, they often seem to act with malicious, mindful intent. A tornado forms as a thunderstorm approaches. In the lower atmosphere, increased wind speeds create a horizontal but visible spinning tube. Once the storm rumbles through, rising air tilts this tube from its horizontal position to the more recognizable vertical funnel shape. From there, tornadoes can have wind speeds up to 320 miles per hour and cause a great deal of destruction where they touch the earth. They uproot trees, flatten houses, and send cars flying through the air like frisbees. The sound is often described as a freight train barreling through your home. Tornadoes don't just pop into existence, they develop out of thunderstorms, where there's already a steady upward flow of warm, low-pressure air to get things started. In supercell thunderstorms, the updrafts are particularly strong. If they're strong enough, a vortex of air can develop just like a vortex of water forms in a sink. This forerunner to the tornado is called a mesocyclone and is typically 2 to 6 miles wide. When a mesocyclone forms, there's a roughly 50% chance that the storm will escalate into a tornado in around 30 minutes. Tornadoes are more common in the United States than anywhere else in the world, but no place in the world, except maybe Antarctica, is completely safe from them. The United States leads the world in the number of tornadoes with an average of 1,000 a year. According to the National Climatic Data Center, Canada is number 2, but only gets an average of 100 tornadoes annually. However, the United Kingdom has more tornadoes, relative to its land area, than any other country. Most of those tornadoes are weak ones, fortunately. Other tornado hotspots include Northern Europe, Western Asia, Bangladesh, Japan, Australia, New Zealand, China, South Africa, and Argentina. And tornadoes can not only strike almost anywhere, they can also strike at almost any time. Unlike most natural disasters, being caught in the middle of a tornado is actually survivable. There have been multiple reports from people who were caught inside the eye of a tornado and have walked away without any injuries. On June 22, 1928, Mr. Keller was one of those people. In his account of events, he mentioned that everything was as still as death. He reported smelling a strong, grassy smell and had trouble breathing. When he looked up, he saw the circular opening directly overhead and estimated it to be roughly 50 to 100 feet in diameter and about half a mile high. The rotating cloud walls were made clearly visible by constant bursts of lightning that zigzagged from side to side. He also noticed a lot of smaller tornadoes forming and breaking free, making a loud hissing sound. The tornado then passed, skipping over his house and smashing the home of his neighbor. Matt Sutter was 19 years old when he had an experience he will never forget. According to the National Weather Service, there was a severe weather outbreak that led to several tornadoes in the Missouri Ozark on the afternoon of March 12, 2006 that lasted through the evening. More than a dozen tornadoes spawned from the supercell thunderstorms that day, claiming the lives of two people. But Matt was lucky. As an EF2 tornado ripped through his grandmother's mobile home in Fordland that evening, Sutter was swept up inside the twister. Records show Sutter was unconscious during this time because he had been struck on the head by a lamp in the mobile home. He woke up sometime later in a grassy field after being thrown over a barbed wire fence. He suffered just scratched feet and a head injury from the lamp, but he does hold the Guinness World Record for the longest distance anyone has ever been thrown by a tornado and survived, at 1,307 feet. While most storms are weak and occur in sparsely populated areas, tornadoes have been known to hit large metropolitan areas, and they've inflicted heavy casualties on many towns and cities. In 1925, the infamous U.S. Tri-State Twister hit parts of Missouri, Illinois, and Indiana, claiming 695 lives. A majority of those lives were taken due to uprooted trees and debris turning into deadly missiles. Not forgetting that if you happen to be driving when a storm hits, your car could be pushed off the road or overturned, causing injury if not death. As soon as debris is carried upward, it's usually spun out of the vortex. Only a very small percentage of all debris is carried aloft, but in rare cases, cars and trucks can find their way into that maximum uplift area. After tornadoes on April 27, 2011 struck Alabama, reports began surfacing of debris that was picked up in one city and deposited in another. Of course, tornadoes can also cause fires to start, as they often tear down electricity lines while wreaking havoc. If this happens near you, it could set surrounding debris on fire and present a potentially fatal situation. There is also something called a fire tornado, which is as horrible as it sounds, and this can obviously be fatal should you be caught in one or struck by one. A fire tornado can manifest when the winds of a wildfire circulate to create a rotating eddy of air. This hot vortex can suck in combustible gases and burning debris in a deadly traveling mixture. If you were unlucky enough to be trapped inside the vortex of a tornado, it's possible that the sudden onset of negative air pressure and upward winds could suck the air right out of your lungs. Should this happen for longer than 3 or 4 minutes, pulmonary specialists say you would die from a lack of oxygen in your system. So, what should you do if a tornado hits your area? According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, you should seek shelter in the lowest part of your home, such as a basement or storm shelter if you have one. Get under something sturdy like a heavy table and cover your body with a blanket or a mattress for added protection. Following this, cross your fingers and remind yourself that most people do survive tornadoes. Would you be prepared if the worst was to happen? Where would you hide? Let us know in the comments box and please like this video if you've enjoyed it. If you want to see more videos like this one, then subscribe to Brain Impact for more. Thanks for watching.